Hey guys, it's Lindsay and welcome back to my channel. So today starts a new reading log for me. It is currently Monday, May 2nd, and it has been a day. This week is gonna be a little bit of a different one. I do have a final presentation for grad school, and it's important because it does go to the board of directors and it determines whether or not I get my master's degree or not. So the presentation is pretty big, so we'll definitely see what happens, but I wanted to give you an update on some of the reading plans that I have for this week. I don't have much, so I really am only planning on reading two books this week, maybe three, we'll see, but I have started listening to A Touch of Ruin by Scarlett St. Clair. I'm currently on chapter 7, which is page 112. Not hating it, however, I'm slowly starting to hate Persephone. She is very annoying. Her jealousy gets to her so quickly, and she doesn't let things play out. She just assumes the worst out of people, and it's already starting to bother the crap out of me. So we'll see whether or not I actually finish that book. And then the other book that I have started reading is Say It's Forever by A.L. Jackson. I just started this today. I am on chapter 6, which is page 64. Very much enjoying it. So I have those two books. That's all I have. And then if I get to it, great. If not, not a big deal. And that's A Touch of Malice, which is book 3. It all depends on if I like A Touch of Ruin, because if I don't like A Touch of Ruin, then I don't know if I'm going to want to read that this week or not. I might want to pick something else up. So we'll see. But that is my reading update for now. Like I said, I've got a few things that are of importance this week, and then I will be able to focus more on my reading. So that's all I got. I'm going to go hop in the shower because this is looking a mess. It's already 10 p.m. I gotta get up early in the morning to go to my office. So we're gonna go take care of this hot mess real quick. And I will see you guys probably tomorrow after I get home from work. I may even finish a book tomorrow. Who knows? Who knows? But I will see you guys a little bit later on. Hey guys, so it is now Tuesday, May 3rd. It is currently 11:24 p.m. I just finished grad school and I don't know how to feel about it yet. I'm sure it'll hit me tomorrow. But I did my final presentation. It is turned in. My last little couple of assignments that I needed to do are done. And so now I just have all sorts of free time. But I did want to give you a kind of a reading update. So I did not read any more of Say It's Forever by A.L. Jackson. I am currently on page, currently on page 82 of this. So I may have read a little bit last night, but didn't update y'all. And then I have not read any more of A Touch of Malice. I am currently on page 112, so I will hopefully be listening to this one probably Thursday, but I am currently reading another audiobook. However, I needed to do this first, so I did complete a book today. I read Bound by Vengeance by Cora Riley, which is book 5 in the Born in Blood Mafia Chronicles. And that means I'm like almost done with the series. So the series has 8 books in it. I'm actually currently on book 6, which is Bound by Blood. Bound by Love. And this is Aria and Luca. They have a second book, and that's what this one is. I am currently 60% into this one. We'll hopefully be finishing this up either tomorrow or Thursday. But that's it. that's all I've got. Like, I'm still kind of in a weird, like, space of, like, holy crap, I'm done with school. Like, I have all this time to do what I want now, and I don't know what to do with it. So, I'm just lost for words is what it is. But I did want to give y'all a little bit of an update. As far as anything else being read tonight, probably not. Probably going to watch the rest of this YouTube video, and then go to bed because I'm tired. It's been a day, and I am exhausted. My brain can finally be done with taking in information. Anyway, so tomorrow's reading plans. I don't really have any. Like I said, I'm still kind of in a state of shock of like, holy crap, I'm done with grad school and don't know what to do with my life. And that's where I'm currently sitting. Like, that's literally all I can think of right now is, holy cow, I'm done. And that's it. So, I will probably, hopefully, read a little bit more of Say It's Forever by A.L. Jackson. My plan right now, is to read not so much tonight, but definitely tomorrow. So I have planned to get hopefully to page 200, which is chapter 19. So that's 11 chapters, and this book is really not that hard to read. It's actually really, like, it reads very easily, and I will hopefully be finishing that. But I do have 3 books that I'm currently reading at the moment, and will hopefully be finishing by the end of the week. And if I do that, that means I have reached my Goodreads goal for the year. That means I would have read 52 books total already in 4 complete months in the first week of May. Like, holy cow, that's a lot. So, anyway, I am going to get ready for bed, recharge, and probably talk to you guys tomorrow, because, yeah. Anyway, all right, I'm gonna go, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Hey guys, so I have been a very crappy vlogger this week. After I finished my project for school, I just kind of wanted to take a break, and just not do anything for a couple of days, which is what I did. So it is now Sunday, May 8th. It is 3:45 in the afternoon, and I figured I would update you guys on what has happened the last couple of days. So, the last clip that was on here, was me finishing my project for school. I am officially done with my master's program, and I will be graduating on Thursday the 12th, which I'm really excited about. I might be able to vlog a little bit of that, but chances are it's just gonna be pictures and maybe a little bit of videos, but we'll see. But I wanted to give you an update of my reading. So I think the last time I updated you, I was 60% into Bound by Love by Cora Riley. I am still 60% into that book. I have not continued on with it, and I probably won't get back to it until next week. And then I started actually reading Say It's Forever by A.L. Jackson, and I am on page 280, so I'll probably finish this either tonight or tomorrow. It just depends on how many things I still have left to do for school. And then I made the decision to start reading a book that I've seen all over Instagram and YouTube and everything, and that is The Zodiac Academy. So I have the first four books plus this book, but as told by the boys. So I have five of these books total. And I am currently on page 171, which is chapter 10. It's good so far. I mean, there's nothing really to report. I mean, yeah, there's a lot of bullying in this book. So if you are not a fan of reading about bullying, then I suggest not reading that book. I am told that the later books get a lot better. So I am hoping that that is true and we can move on from the current bullying that is happening. And then I also read a little bit more of A Touch of Ruin by Scarlett St. Clair. I am currently on page 175. So read a little bit more of that. My plan for next week is probably to finish all of the books that I've started this week and just finish them next week and maybe add in something else, but I won't really determine that until tomorrow and see how much I actually get done as far as the audiobooks are concerned. So that's it for my reading update. However, I went to the bookstore yesterday after work, as one does, and I just wanted to get a few things. I ended up coming home with 10 books. That's a lot. And then also when I got home from work today, I have a package. So have a little bit of a book haul that's going to be going on right now. I'm not going to do a separate video of it. This stuff is pretty easy. So we're just going to go through it real quick. But I did end up going to two different Barnes & Nobles yesterday, or Barnes & Noble yesterday, and I ended up picking up 7 books at one and 3 at another. Granted, out of these 10 books, I have read 5 of them, so I don't have to put them in my TBR pile. I have read them already. I just wanted physical copies of them, and they were a little bit more expensive on Amazon than they were at Barnes & Noble. Plus, I have a membership at Barnes & Noble, so I went ahead and just bought them there. And so the series I'm talking about is the Off Campus series by Elle Kennedy. I bought the 5 books. I have not read I've read the Briar U series as well, but I have not gotten them in physical copy. I was planning on doing it yesterday, but figured 7 at the bookstore was enough. So I did buy the first 5. I have read this one, The Deal. Garrett and Hannah, two of my favorite people. This one is Grace and John, or Logan. A lot of people just call him Logan. This one is really, really good. I loved it. The Score, who was this one? Dean and Allie, they were really cute. I think I had a little bit of a problem with Allie, if I'm not mistaken, but we'll see. I think I have to go back and look and see what I really thought about her, but overall, loved it. The Goal is Tucker and Sabrina. This book, I don't remember much about this one, so I'll have to probably reread at some point. Excuse me. And then the last one, this one I have not read. So this is The Legacy. This is Off Campus. This is 4 stories of the 4 couples from the first 4 books, and you don't really know who is who. So it says a wedding, a proposal, an elopement, and a surprise pregnancy. So you kind of figure out what happens with all 4 of them. It's kind of like one big epilogue, but for the entire series. So I look forward to rereading these and just reliving at Briar University, and I'm really excited. So I did get those. The last two I got at that location was Oaths and Omissions by Savar Miller. This is the 3rd book in the Monsters and Muses series. I have read Promises and Pomegranates. I have not read Virtues and Virtuosos, and I have not obviously read this one either. I saw it at Barnes & Noble. It is cheaper to buy it at Barnes & Noble than it was on Amazon. So I just went ahead and picked it up. I'm excited because this one is about, what is his name? Jonas. Sorry, I had to look it up. This one's about Jonas, so I'm really excited about this. And we'll see, because I wanted to know about Jonas's story when I read the first one. So looking forward to this. And then the last book I got at that location is Lilac, and this is by B.B. Reed. This is a reverse harem. It is a girl in a band, and all of the, you know, characters are with her. So we'll see what happens. I am not entirely sure. I have not read a reverse harem in a while. So we'll definitely see what I think about this one. It is a long book. It's 537 pages. It's a lot. Jeez Louise. So anyway, really excited to read this, see what the hype is about. I know some people like this, some people hate it. So I am really excited to see what I think of this one. And then I went to a second Barnes & Noble location, picked up three books while I was there. The first one being, I have no idea how to say this, Respotic? I don't know, by Laura Thalassa. I've heard good things about this. This is the first book in the Bargainer series, and we'll see. I've heard good things, I've heard bad things, but this author also wrote the Four Horsemen series, so I have the first book, Pestilence, but nothing else. So we'll see about this one. I'm not entirely sure yet, but looking forward to it nevertheless. Next book I had, I thought I had bought, but apparently I didn't, but I thought I did. And that is The Cheat Sheet by Sarah Adams. Just a cute little rom-com that I'm sure has something to do with football and ballet from what it looks like on the cover. I've seen this multiple times ever since every time I go to the bookstore, I always see this book. So we just decided today to get it. So picked that up and super excited about it. And then probably my most favorite one that I picked up at the store, and I've since bought the second volume, and that is Heartstopper Volume 1 by Alice Oseman, I think is how you say her name. I'm super excited. This graphic novel series has since been turned into a Netflix TV show. I have not watched it yet because I was waiting for the graphic novels. So I have the first one. The second one is being shipped to me through Barnes & Noble because, again, it was cheaper on Barnes & Noble than it was at Amazon for some reason. And then I have not ordered the third or fourth volume. I think I will be ordering those soon, but we'll see. I want to see what I think about this one before I get the third and fourth one. I'm really looking forward to these. But those are all the books that I got at Barnes & Noble. I did end up making a Amazon purchase on Friday, which is what my ALEXA is reminding me of. I'm not going to say her name. But anyway, I got this package in the mail today. Actually, as I was coming home from my second job today, the postman was on our street, so he ended up just handing me this package. I already know what's in here because I'm super excited. One of the books in here I wanted to pre-order, but it wasn't available for pre-order, so I had to wait until it actually hit, and that is Founded on Deception by Kat Singleton. This mixtape series is so good. Like, the first two books, Founded on Goodbye and Founded on Temptation, so good, and I am really looking forward to getting to this one. I don't have any idea. Like, I'm trying to remember who some of these characters were, because, like, I know who Aiden is. Aiden is the brother of, I think, Nash, maybe? Yes. And then Monica, I don't remember who Monica is. I don't know if we've been introduced to her or if she was the crazy, like, manager. I'm not entirely sure. I don't remember. It's been a minute. So we'll see. I am very excited to get to this. And it might be a minute before I get to it, but I will get to it. And then the last three books I bought, they are just little novellas. If you don't know this about me, I am obsessed with Jane Ryland. She is one of my favorite authors. And so I ended up picking up some of her Power Tool series. I had the fourth book, and then I had, I don't remember if it was the sixth book, but I had a few of them. So I ended up picking up the first three books. They are tiny because they're not very, they're six, you know, six chapters long. They don't even have page numbers. Or actually, they do. It's just like the first half of this book is the actual book. It's only 96 pages, and then the rest of it's a sneak peek of this book here. And then, you know, Kayla's gift. I don't remember which one is which. I want to say, hold on. So I think it's Kate's Crew, then Morgan's Surprise, then Kayla's Gift. So I think this is how it goes, is these first three. And then I have Devin's Pair after this one, which is book four. These I think are available to listen to on Scribd, so I'll probably just knock these out in one day so that they are actually read. So that's it. That the like they're just these probably could have been in a bind up and I would have been fine with it. But I am super excited to have them on my shelves now, and they will be read rather quickly. So I'm super excited. And then the last thing that I have for you guys today is I bought some stickers off of Etsy, some bookish stickers. So I ended up just getting a cute, you know, a couple of cute little things. Let me go ahead and grab these out. I ended up buying five total stickers. She did send me some freebies, which I thought was really sweet. She didn't have to do that, but she did. I will leave the Etsy shop in the link in the description below so you guys can go check her out. But some of the books, some of the stickers I got was this one says, "I dust my shelves, but my books are still filthy." So there's that one. Then I have one that says, "Proud to be a raunchy romance reader," and it looks like this. And then I have one that is just like a book stack, and it has a bunch of different dark romance tropes on it. So you have dark romance, grumpy sunshine, mafia, slow burn, and then reverse harem is on this one. So I've gotten this. The next one I have is "Warning, my books are spicy." So there's this one here. And then probably my favorite one is "I read because punching people is frowned upon," and that one looks like this. And then the two freebies that she gave me are just little cute ones. And it says one says, I fell in love at the bookstore," so it's just a cute little one. And then the other one says, "Books are my favorite," and it looks like that. So if you guys are interested, I'll leave a link in the description box below so you can go check out her shop. She's very sweet. I didn't really have any problems with her, and it shipped very quickly. So I'm super excited about that. But that is pretty much it, y'all. I have a lot of things to put away to do before we head out for Mother's Day dinner, and I want to wish a happy Mother's Day to all our mamas out there. I am not personally a mother, but I am an auntie. I have a niece. But I praise every woman who is able to have children or has children willingly. I am not that person at this moment in time, but I appreciate moms nonetheless. You're doing the best you can, and I very much appreciate you for it. So, anyway, that is what I've got for you today. I am going to probably listen to the rest of, or at least a little bit more of my audiobook while I input all of this stuff into my spreadsheet and update my spreadsheets and all of that. And then I will either let you know how I did at the end of the night tonight or tomorrow morning, and we'll just cut off the vlog then. So with that being said, I will check in with you guys a little bit later. And yeah, so I'll see you then. Hey guys, so it is now Tuesday, May 10th. So I'm gonna go ahead and end this vlog here. I haven't done pretty much anything. Last weekend, I didn't finish anything on Sunday. I read a little bit more of Say It's Forever by A.L. Jackson, but I didn't actually complete anything else. So last week was a little bit of a let's take a break week. And I read one book, and that is Bound by Vengeance by Cora Riley. And even then, it was a really short audiobook. But that's totally okay. You can have those kind of weeks. And I'm really sorry that if this vlog is just garbage, it is what it is. However, there was a book haul in it, so there you go. You know, some of the people who don't watch my vlogs regularly won't know that there was a book haul. So anyway, I'm going to end the vlog here. I'm going to start next week's vlog today because I've done some pretty good reading today and I want to update you guys. But anyway, with that being said, I really appreciate you guys for watching these videos. If you have a video suggestion or any book recommendations, please let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you next time.